for the gentrification of downtown Brooklyn. Before Williamsburg became techno mecca. Before there was a lounge on every corner in Fort Greene. Before there were 10 clubs on Atlantic Avenue. Before my job at Tommy Boy. Before a cat named Jerome ran a label out of his first floor apartment on Lafayette Street with a girl named Shauna. Before Kim Lightfoot was my neighbor, there were people responsible for my education and upbringing in this thing we call house. Mancuso, a man who played the most incredible music I had ever heard and allowed me to understand that it was possible to play whatever kind of music you wanted to the right audience. Then there was Dave Morales, who I met at the Law. David was a pretty incredible dancer, and he told me he was gonna start a Friday night party out in Flatbush, at a place called the Ozone Layer. Little did I know, at that time, I was watching history unfold. He started doing parties also at another spot on Saturday, called the Biltmore Ballroom, and shared his stage with new emerging talent, such as Colonel Abrams with the hit "Music Is the Answer," Sable Jeffries with the hit "A Love So Special," keyboard players like Boy Jarvis. David was on his way to becoming a star. It wasn't long before he was playing everywhere. Inferno, Zanzibar, Red Zone, the world. And I guess the rest is history. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. Two guys showed me the ropes to the whole promotion game. Willie Wall and Oscar Fuller. Willie was half of the team of Wall and Robertson, of the Wall and Robertson Project, with high-powered producer and radio DJ John Robertson, who brought us the house music anthem, Family Prayer. Willie and Oscar were doing parties all over the city, and Oscar was pretty tight to a cat named Jason Lowe, who brought us the anthem, The Warning. They taught me this hustle called promotion, and taught me, like all hustles, it can't be learned in school, and it damn sure ain't fair. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. Kings of Brooklyn. I landed a record job at a very prominent hip-hop label, and then realized once I got that job, I still wasn't totally fulfilled in my search and quest for music. I guess it showed and reflected in my work because I only had that job for about a year. But things happen for a reason. And by leaving that place, I was blessed with my next blessing. That's the place where I met my favorite mentor, a guy named Strafe, who owned a record label called STD, and gave the world one of the house music anthems that will never be forgotten, called Set It Off. He took a concern about my music career. He told me things people in the music industry never did before. He made me a better DJ. He thought that I would be a good singer, spoken word artist. He taught me structure and taught me how to write songs. He also taught me how not to be taken advantage of as an artist by the music industry. And for those things, I am truly thankful. I will never be able to thank these people enough for sharing their many gifts with me. So to me, these cats, are the true kings of Brooklyn.